Bear will probably say something. He always says something. Okay. He's always got something good to say.
Still pushing buttons?
Live from downtown Houston is Ginger Crumb. No, we're going to change that to Cookie Crumb. Cookie Crumb Monday. Live with Sammy, naturally. Always the bear. The bear's always present. And we must find Ginger somewhere.
Hi.
There she is.
All right. Hi, welcome everybody. So I want to welcome you to our live Monday night show. This is always fun. I love Monday shows. It's just a fresh week. I've got some fresh ideas.
Oh, yeah. I love Monday shows, too.
John really loves Monday shows. And here's why I like them. We had some fun today. We did figured out how to do a little video with the phone and shot it from the restaurant tonight. It was about 1 minute. Just to let some of you guys know we were doing a live show. And it was, you know, it was kind of a little weird. Everything was a little distorted and stuff. You know, we haven't got all the toys figured out. But, you know, we had someone from Australia see it and someone from England see it. Here I am eating at a restaurant in Houston, Texas, and it went out to the world. Isn't that just extraordinary when you think about it? Do you remember? Gosh, you know, I hate to do this. There's always...
Do you remember? Oh, here we go. Memory lane.
Memory lane with the, you know, you're getting older when you start all conversations with do you remember, right? Doesn't, can't have enough facelifts to fix that conversation, right? But anyway, the idea is that back in the day, that's what they used to say.
Yeah, back in the day.
Kids, and the kids said that. The kids are always saying that. Back in the day, they don't got no day. This. It goes back when, you know, you're calling downtown Houston from Tomball. You know, you could rack up $50 in long distance bills and you hadn't gone 20 miles. I mean, you think about when taxi meters, taxi cab rides were free compared to a long distance phone call. Remember? So, you know, just somebody in England hears it, somebody from Australia hears it. Just shout out to, you know, our friends around the world. That
they're not
here.
Hearing you for some reason.
Who's not hearing me?
I don't know, but I'm hearing you fine.
Well, I had this great speech. No one's hearing it?
Well, I'm not sure. Can you raise your hand? I'd love to say that. Raise your hand if you can hear Ginger.
Yeah, because I mean, I don't want to. Who knows what I just said? You know, this was intuitive brilliance here. You know, impromptu.
It was one of those moments.
Impromptu moments.
An impromptu moment. And what is impromptu? Something that's never going to happen again.
That's it. So
it's
you
gone.
Know what I mean? And you just,
okay,
you know.
But she's not loud. She went out again.
Oh, well, look! Here's my microphone. It's on right here. There it is.
I'm wondering, let me turn mine down and see if I'm hearing you.
Okay. All right. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Turn your volume up, you guys.
More.
How about this?
I'll bring you up louder than normal.
Okay. Hey, did you know what I was watching a video on how to be a better speaker, and one of the things they said to do was talk in a voice that was slightly louder than you would normally do it, and it's impossible to add the ums and the ers.
The ums and the ers?
Well, yes, that's when you're trying to come up with a thought, you know, it's or whatever. And they said if you talk, you know, we'll try. I'm going to speak a little louder than I normally do tonight. Let's see if there's less of that.
I've turned you up.
What was that?
I've turned you up.
Okay, all right. So now tonight, what we're going to do is something really fun. We're going to be painting a balcony window with flowers. And that's our big plan tonight. And I'm going to really, some of the things that what I've noticed when people are painting flowers is that there's a concept, there's like a formula, okay, for doing it. And once you get this down, I don't care how many flowers you put in, how many gardens, if you can do it like this, you've got it made and it becomes really simple. Then you just have to decide what flowers look nice next to which. And you've got, you know, your color wheel, which kind of gives you a clue about that. So really, it takes all, it's so simple, okay? And I think there's a lot of different ways to explain things. And for instance, this is, I'm just gonna hold it up. This is the painting we're gonna be painting tonight, a little 8x10 canvas. And while we're waiting for people to show up, because you know, just right around 7:30 when we start, you know, people are kind of tuning in. So if you haven't been to our channel before, please subscribe and ask your friends to subscribe. Let people know about us and be sure to, if you like this video, share it with others. That's real important. It helps us be seen on YouTube. There's millions of little voices out there and YouTube gets a little overwhelmed. There's search engines and we don't always show up places where people might want
to
paint.
We seem to be the orphans.
We're like the orphans, you guys, so any help is appreciated. We're going to do something a little different tonight. I normally don't use this color. This is called Unbleached Titanium. I mean, I could have a tube of this for 10 years. I don't use it very often. It is sort of like a parchment color.
It's pretty.
But our background, it's pretty, and I'm going to show you how we're going to use that. And if, John, would you scoot down to our...
I love when you say scoot down.
Just bring the camera down to our palette while we're talking. And incidentally, if you're wondering, who's John? John Little is our executive producer, the other owner of GingerCookLive.Gallery. He's our tech wizard. People always say, oh, gosh, I take painting lessons over the internet, but I'm just not good with computers. Yeah, but John is, and John is your guy. John's the guy that everybody says, I have an iPad and I don't know what button to push. And then he writes back, and I watch him shoot special videos for people to explain stuff they don't understand. We have the best tech service. Ask anybody of anybody on the internet. I don't care what they're selling. They don't got John, and John will explain it to you. So if you have been holding off going over to GingerCookLive.Gallery and not taking classes because you worry that the internet's going to confuse you, worry no more, because you've got John. In fact, right up here, he's up here right now adjusting something. Okay.
I moved the cameras and I had to unplug somebody.
So he unplugged somebody and he's plugging somebody back in. See, this is what John does. He's just on top of this. So we're putting out these two colors, white, unbleached titanium, and then I want to put out a burnt sienna. I'm going to show you how we're going to do the background. Now, I've already painted the background.
We have a question over here.
Sure, a question, yeah.
Dorothy, I believe from the UK, is asking, is that the same as buff titanium?
I believe it is, Dorothy. Buff titanium and unbleached titanium, I think, are the same thing. I'm not sure. Liquitex calls it unbleached, but it's the color of parchment, so it's got to be pretty close. You could mix it if you didn't have it. In fact, we'll talk about that, too. So here's a little burnt sienna, okay? And while I'm putting paint out, I want to give a shout-out to Kim and... Wendy, our moderators. These guys are just volunteers. They make our live shows possible. They keep all
Sandra's
the
on tonight too.
Oh, who?
Sandra.
And Sandra. Want to shout out to Sandra. Thank you very much. These guys are the ones that are like our police. They keep kind of strange, quirky people out of our room so you guys can have pleasant chats and enjoy each other and so forth. And we really appreciate them very much. A shout out to them. Now, what I want to do is, you see this background, just to facilitate things, I have done the background already, and I've actually traced the image on. We will have a traceable for you on our website, but I'm going to also show you. You don't have to wait for that. This is so easy.
It really is. It's a bunch of boxes.
I mean, it's just some boxes, man, and a ruler. You can't miss it. But so here's a little, this is real canvas. This is called a Paramount tablet. There's 10 little pieces of canvas in a tablet. You know, you can buy canvas by the roll, all gessoed at the art store, too. Just buy a yard of it and cut it up. You know, that's even cheaper. Did you know that? You know, if you take the scissors to it yourself, interesting. All right, so you've got a little piece of white canvas, and you want to do a little, you don't want one solid color. What you want is this sort of all kind of, you want to make it look like an old stucco building, all right? So what you want to do is kind of every which away. You like that? Every which away, okay? So I'm going to wet the brush, and then I'm going to, you know, and I'm just using kind of a bright 1-inch brush, but just some sort of wide brush like this. And I'm going to get a little unbleached titanium, and I'm going to go up here like this. Doop, 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 doop. And then I'm going to get a little burnt sienna, and I'm going to do that. And then I'm going to get a little unbleached titanium, and I'm going to do that. Kind of some X's. All right, no thought on this, okay? Play some music or something. Have fun,
da,
right?
Da, da, do, da, do, da, do, da. Hey, speaking of that, do you have a die?
Do I have to do what?
You have a die.
Okay,
it's a single dice. Do you have the die?
I have a die. I thought, did I just die? Did
No, not with your singing. No, that was just too beautiful.
Yes, of course it was. If we didn't do this, we could just do this in our spare time. You just stopped it, didn't you? Thinking, oh, God, she's dying on the vine here. Don't let her sing, folks. Stop her now.
No. You were doing fine.
We're going to get some thumbs down in a hurry if she sings, right? See what I'm doing here? A little bit of X's, a little darker in the corner. A little darker around the edges. I just want you to see that there is no, this is easy, cut it, you know, kind of crisscross it. Boop, 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 boop. I have a dice. We're going to play some trivia games here with our dice. We also got a beautiful gifty.
Die. A single die, dice is a die.
Who said that?
I just did. Did you not hear me?
I did.
Is my microphone not working either?
Well, I'm just saying, I know these things have been around for a long time, but I think that that's wrong.
Hey, do you think adding bricks and stucco to this would be too busy?
No, I just didn't have time to do everything.
But you'd also want to do it bigger if you did.
You would want to do it bigger. I would want to do this much bigger and then add real stucco. But we just didn't have time to do all that razzmatazz tonight. Okay, so you see what this dries. Boom. It's dry. Then you go ahead and you can take a little. What I suggest you do is draw it out. Draw your balcony out. This way you can make it any size. You see there's a rectangle here. There's a rectangle here. And then there's two side rectangles with little things going up at an angle. And then a little balcony. This is so simple, okay? So, of course, we don't have a ruler.
You have a ruler. Look at your bucket. Look at your bucket. Look at your bucket.
Oh, in the bucket.
There's five rulers in there.
In the bucket. Yes, rulers. Yes. Of course, they have paint all over them. Who knows what they say, but we have them. All right, so basically, for a little 8x10, this is, turn it around so one can see it. This is like, you know, approximately 6 inches that way. And about, 2.5 inches that way. And then the door itself is 2 inches wide, kind of centered on here. And then each one of these little side piece wings is an inch.
8x10 stretch canvas.
8x10. So if you wanted to make it bigger, you know, you just double that, you know. Like a 16x20, you just make that. Instead of, this is, how tall is this? What does this say? Can you read that, John?
Looks like you're 7 inches.
Yeah, 7 inches from top to bottom. So that'd be 14 inches if you're doing that 16x20. And then, you know, basically, I mean, I'm just going to get out just because I'm your friend here. We'll just do that, right? Chalkboard, right? So then you basically,
3D chalkboard.
You're just going to make a rectangle and then two side rectangles, okay? Here, find the center of this and then these up a little bit higher than this. These go up like that, okay? That was easy, right? Like little ears. Ooh, like a cat. Okay? And then, I mean, you can't, you know, then kind of, you're coming along here, there's your cross piece. Whatever's on this side should be the same amount on that side. Dupe, 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 dupe for your balcony, right? And then you need a board for your balcony. And then, do, 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 do. Do, 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 do. All right, that's really simple, okay? So I know you if you want a traceable, you can have one, but you really don't need one, right? Once you understand, you're just drawing rectangles. So that we have cleared that up, yes?
We've cleared that up. Traceable will be on the website.
Going, what are we drawing? We're doing this. Little bath. Now you see it, okay? So now we're just going to show you the tricky part, which is painting it in. And while we're putting out the paint, we're going to have a question. Our wonderful, we always play trivia on the show now. This is our new thing, art trivia. So here's our dice. Number six, John. We're going into the mystery questions.
I love the mystery questions.
Yes, and while John's doing that, I'm going to put out the paint. It's the same razzmatazz we always do. The only thing that was a little different was the magenta. And this one happens to be design magenta, but it doesn't really matter. You just want some sort of pink flower stuff, okay? So, you know, it's okay. We want cad yellow medium, and we want yellow oxide, we want burnt umber, Dodge Neat purple, ultramarine blue, phthalo blue, and cad red medium. Just all the same culprits. Yes?
All right, are we ready?
I guess.
We have a question.
I give up, are we?
Yeah, I think we are. I think we're ready. Here we go. What word related to color is also a space out of the sunlight and a disrespectful attitude in American slang?
What word related to color has something to do
with
color?
Is also a space out of the sunlight and a disrespectful attitude.
Oh, that's easy. I got it.
In slang. In American slang.
In American slang. Okay, got that.
Okay. So as they come in, we'll see how they do.
Yeah.
How far out is the balcony on the sides?
Oh, good question.
Glad you asked.
I kind of off-centered it. A lot of people would want to put it in the middle. It's more interesting to put it off-center. From the window on the left-hand side, it's like 3 inches. Okay? And down from the top, it's like half an inch. Down from the bottom, it's like, you know, an inch or something. Okay? And then on this side, I guess you want to know this side, that would be 4 inches. Okay, and that's 2 inches of a 4,
I got right? Shady, Krona, Shady, Shade, 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 Shady. That's deep, LOL. Shady, Shady, Shade, Shade, Shade. I thought that they said a color. Shady, Shady, Shade.
It said related shady. To color. Related to color, which is, you know, kind of, you know, they had a reach for
I
that
I don't know
one.
American slang. Well, I can't blame you there. I didn't know this was, well, I guess
well,
shady.
Well, sometimes
is.
In America, for instance, if they think someone is crooked or ill, dishonest, all right, as opposed to...
Questionable, as it were.
Questionably... creative with the law, okay? They're called shady, okay? The shady character. I don't know that that's English. I think that could be England slang. Ask our folks in England. Is it English slang
folks in the UK, have you heard of the term shade or shady for a person? Give some, but yeah, the correct answer is shade.
All right,
give
I'm going to turn my fan
a big
on
round
here.
Of a, oh, please, quietly, though, quietly.
There. Do I have to do the quiet part?
I don't
part?
Know. Is it quiet?
I give up, is it?
No, it's loud. Louder. Sounds like you're taking off over there.
I don't know. It didn't change anything. Whatever it is, it's blowing air now.
Yeah, but it's noisy. It's in my ear.
Well, come fix it. Well, you know, who? Fix it. It's hot in here. Put all these lights on. It's hot. You can turn that thing so I can see it, too. All right, you guys, so you saw yellow oxide, yellow, burnt umber, dusting purple. I want to just say that John and I had a busy day. Monday's very busy for us. One of the things we did was we mailed out about half of the paintings from the auction that was concluded about a week ago. A bunch of them went out today, and each painting got a certificate of authenticity. And this is what one looks like. It says Ginger Cook Certificate of Authenticity, original acrylic painting. It gives the title, the size, the you know what it's on, the date, and it's signed by me, and it's got our you know gold seal with my Ginger Cook Studio stamp. Each and then a picture of the painting, and then our and remember the promise was our
contest.
Painting that we gave away for our contest. And that went to Lori. And Lori, we just did a duplicate. Your certificate's there. Yours went out today, too. So, Lori, you should be getting your original painting, too. It was an auction piece. She won that in one of our games, okay? So, I was talking to another fellow YouTuber today. We were talking about giveaways. And the comment was, well, you know, you've got to know how to do a proper giveaway. I don't know. What is a proper giveaway? I mean, I just find something I think you might want, I give it away, right? I mean, I don't know. What, you know, you got to run a proper giveaway. I've been thinking, huh? Well,
I guess we'll take some input from you guys.
We don't know. What? How should a proper giveaway be done?
Was the last giveaway a proper giveaway, or can we improve on our giveaway?
Can we improve on our giveaways? I don't know. You know, I mean, we did the secret word. I thought that was kind of fun. Okay, this is what we're painting today. So I'm going to use a little half. This is, what is this? Let me put my glasses on. We've got, you think
the
they were just
traceable
up for a show, 3/8 inch.
Hold on a second. The what? Traceable is not on the website as of yet.
But it will be. So I just did this, you know, I just did this
like
painting
like
an hour ago or something, you know, 2 hours ago. Give me a break here, right? So I was going to do something else and change my mind. I had a panic attack this morning and decided that I didn't like what we had for tonight and I had to come up with something else. All right, so here's what you want with a deal like this. You want some tape. I have inch tape, quarter inch tape, small tape. Okay, this is artist tape, not masking tape. And one of the things you can do with tape like this is that you can use it to make straight lines with. Like, for instance, like right here. We'll see. Here, let's do that. This is how wide our windows are, right? Approximately about like that. This is how wide our windows are. Okay, so I'm going to put some tape there. This is the inch wide tape. And then I'm going to put some tape here. People always say, how do you decide how wide to make something? I look at my tape, see what I got, right? Seriously, you can pull it off and kind of reline it up, you know, make sure it's straight, okay?
The consensus is the last giveaway was great. If you'd like me to read a few comments, your giveaways are great. Last giveaway was awesome. I thought it was quite a proper giveaway, all kinds of fun. I think the Ginger decides what a proper giveaway is. You can improve by picking me next time, LOL. You can do your giveaways any way you want, LOL.
Okay.
Your giveaway was simple and fun, so therefore great.
Thank you. Because I'm just, you know, I've just got this comment. Well, if you understood how to do a proper giveaway, You know, and because, you know, what's just going, yeah, well, okay. Guess I don't. See, I'm doing the small tape here, right?
I thought we knew
right?
what we were doing.
I thought we did okay. You know what I mean? I just did. Now, see my fingernail, but this is called, look, if you go to art school, they tell you when you do this, it's called burnishing the tape. I think it should be called squishing because that's what you're doing. You're squishing down the seams like this. And then probably before I did that, I should have taken a clear triangle. I had a small one here somewhere. Here, there's a little one, okay? And, you know, you line it up on the top here, just to double check to make sure you have it straight. See, let's just move all hazardous paint out of the way, okay? See, like this, I'm lining it up here at the top. If this is parallel to the top and bottom of the canvas, see, now this little piece of tape is slightly off here. I mean, it's just good enough for government work, but slightly off, okay? But how about the middle ones? How'd they do with those? Yeah, okay, so good enough, right? But it doesn't hurt to check. Sometimes you don't see it, and then everything gets cattywampus sooner than you want.
Cattywampus.
Do you guys ever say that,
cattywampus? Yeah, cattywampus, yep.
Cattywampus.
I love that one.
We just, we were talking about all the old things that people used to say. All right, we're going to take a little bit of burnt umber, okay? And a tiny bit of burnt sienna. The two of them together make sort of this darker brown, and come up here in the center like this. And the trick with tape is to always go overlap the tape, okay? So I'm going to come down here like this. I'm going to overlap the tape, bring this all the way down, put a little more burnt umber with it. And now I could, if I wanted to, and I'm just saying I could, just an example, if I was a persnickety, you like that word?
Oh, another one. Yeah, a persnickety.
Another good persnickety. My sister was persnickety. She used to come to my house when she was alive, and she'd run her fingers over the top of the cupboards and comment on whether I dusted or not, you know? and then she'd offer to clean the house. And I, listen, knock yourself out. If it's that important to you, you know what I mean? And so then I would reciprocate. When I go to her house, I'd do the same thing. Not because I gave a rip of whether she had any dust, but it seemed to be important to her that I would notice that she had none. Just sorry. My sister was a lovely person. Okay, so we're getting a little bit up. Just some burnt sienna here, nothing too clever. We're going to come down like this.
So that's straight burnt sienna right out of the tube?
Just right out of the tube. Burnt sienna, I'm just not getting too clever here, okay? I mean, we're clever, but we're just going to keep it. We're going to keep it easy. And I don't think I need to go too far down, but I could, you see? It doesn't matter. I'm going to paint over it anyway, but there we go.
Cindy Lou would like to know, where can I find a triangle like Ginger? Been looking, can't find one that big.
Oh, gosh, they come in all kinds of sizes. I've got some giant ones. I've got giant ones, much bigger than that.
Yeah, that's a small one.
The thing is, that you should be a good triangle. You sock folders, you shouldn't allow paint to get all over your triangle. You should.
And I know I wouldn't.
I know you wouldn't, John. But, you know, this is not probably good triangle husbandry.
No, it is not. Oh, I like that one.
Husbandry, yes. The triangle. Okay, so now, look, that doesn't look like anything, does it? Just, what does that mean? Nothing. But that's what we did. So
then what? It looks like a mess.
It does. So then you take the tape off. Oh. Look at that.
Look at the lines you're getting.
Now, if you over tape stuff, it will look taped. So the trick is tape some things and then try to do some stuff by hand, okay? So that it looks more painted and less taped. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
So you can really overdo it with the tape. I mean, you could get, particularly if you were doing a big street scene, you can really overdo it. Okay, so there we go. Look at that. Are you impressed? Look at that. How cool is that? Now, what else do I know? Well, I know that down here, I want something kind of dark. So I'm going to take some dazzling purple and some burnt umber, and I'm going to come under here like this. Now, I'm not going to tape it, but I'm going to come under here like this, and I'm going to create a little tiny water on the tip of the brush so that it's kind of smooth there. What I want to do is I want to create this sort of log, and logs like this, these sort of balcony logs, they don't have to be too perfect. I've got the other one a little too perfect, and they really are kind of prettier if they're not too perfect. There you go. So we're going to say that there's our log here like that underneath, and then probably off to the, I think I've got it right here, and then we're going to say here's some things holding it up. Okay,
some
like that.
Some things holding it up.
Yeah, whatever these things are. They're holding it up. These underneath things here. Holding up our stuff. Okay. So we've got that. Okay. Now, what else could we do? Well, you know, we could do some stuff. What? Well, we could, for instance, I mean, while this is, before we have to dry it, You're sitting and saying, what else could we do when? Well, before we have to dry it. We could, for instance, come along here. I want a little edge on these, so I could come down here. See, notice I'm pulling it between the two fingers.
No, isn't that dark wet?
Yeah, it is, but I'm not going to touch it.
Ooh, you're that good.
I'm just this sort of little Russian roulette here with that. It's just I'm not that good. I'm just that bold. How's that?
Okay.
There, like that. And I'm going to do this on the other side too. Okay. Like this, and you always make a little bit longer piece than you need. That's a little trick with tape. See, I'm going to lodge it there, kind of fold it down, then use your palette knife to cut it off. You like that?
Where's the birthday cake video?
I give up. Where's the birthday cake video?
Is it?
I think we have it for rent.
We don't. Sale. It's not available.
It's not available anymore unless you bought. It's for rent or sale. I think it's for rent or sale right now.
The rent or sale over on Vimeo.
So I'm going to add a little bit of white to this burnt sienna here, like that. Maybe a little even of the unbleached titanium, kind of lighten that up, but not doing all this. A little more there. Okay, now I'm going to come next to here like this. Just put a little yellow oxide in that, kind of warm that up. So I'm going to come right next to the.
Oh, thank you, Miss Angie, for the quick donation. We do appreciate that.
Oh, thanks, you guys. That's so lovely. All right, so there you go. See, now I'm being kind of right next to my. My stuff on each side, and I've got the taped on one end, a little more burnt sienna in that, or yellow oxide in that, here, right next to here. So I'm right next to my taped line. I'm using an angle brush, okay?
Looks like a 3/8 inch.
Yeah, and I can push pretty hard. I don't have to be that careful. I just have to keep this line straight. Now when I take this off, see, you're going, oh, look at that. See, so it has the perception of very neat, but one line isn't as neat, if that sort of makes sense, right?
Sort of,
right? Okay, so now what could I do? Can I do anything else? Well, I could take a little yellow oxide and a little cadmium medium, kind of make a little orange color. I could put some in here like this, just to indicate some, just as a board, you know, like this, and we'll just come down here like this. And let's say that's the shadow on that. So there you go, something like that. All right, so that's all we're doing here. Nothing tricky. This is not a tricky piece.
Sandra wants to know, can I ask a question about the Wave and Water Masterclass latest painting?
Sure.
Ask away.
Sure, ask away.
My guess is, where is it?
That's a good question. I give up. Where is it?
Day one is up there. Day two, I'm still working on. It's 5 pieces currently, and I think I've got another 4 pieces to go. It's a biggie.
About Heartbreak at Sea.
Heartbreak at Sea.
Yeah.
That's not completely up there yet? Wait a minute. I thought that one was. I'm getting so confused. I'm getting so far behind.
Okay, so I put a little cross piece here, and you'll notice I didn't tape it, right? I just kind of free-handed that in. I felt pretty confident I could do that. Now I'm going to take a little bit of cad red medium and a little yellow, okay? And I'm going to come right along the inside of this one, like this, and just come down here like that, and come up here like that on the sides. If this is the rail, let's just come up about another inch above the rail and go up at a slight angle, kind of following that angle. Do it the same on both sides. Okay, so now we've got a little bit of light going across the top. See, I mean, you could tape all this in, but I don't think you have to. Once you've got the straight line,
the only day
you
one's
should
up.
Be okay.
Corey's made a comment. Why wouldn't you have left the other tape up on the shutters?
Could have. Sure could have.
Because she's just wild and crazy today.
I could have. I mean, you absolutely, I should, sure could have. Corey's absolutely right.
Oh,
sure.
Apparently you used an antique Matisse color in that. I can't get Matisse here. What can I use to substitute these colors?
Well, it wasn't an antique Matisse color.
No. We're talking Wave and Water. Do you remember that?
What was it?
We haven't done all that.
I think it was an antique white.
So, like a buff then?
You know, so yeah, you know, there's a book that we get back to that book again because the paint colors are a lot like lipsticks. Different manufacturers call them different things. So there's this nifty book, and John will tell you what it is. It's called the art. What is it called? I can't read it from here.
The Artist Handbook of Materials and Techniques,
Artist
Edition,
Handbook of
Ralph
Materials
Mayer.
So it kind of gives you an idea of how where that all crosses over. All right, now while that's drying, let's take some white and some ultramarine blue, okay, like that, okay, and then a tiny bit of raw umber, or burnt umber rather, just a tiny and a tiny bit of phthalo. Kind of, now we've got this pretty blue color. Now let's come in here like this, and let's again paint in our sky like that. Now the first thing, which we're just going to do some sky. We're not getting too clever with the sky. We're just painting in a sky, nothing too fancy. And you could have painted the sky all first and then done the center divider. I think I did it that way the first time, but it really doesn't matter. And again, you could have done a straight edge or come along here if you had some doubts about how close you wanted to get to all of that. So there's our sky. Now we want a little bit darker up at the top of the window. So here's a little ultramarine blue. And while this is still wet, I'll just come up here to the corners and bring it a little bit darker here. Okay, like that. Right next to here. Then I'm going to take a little white, and I'm just going to sort of scribble some white on in here like that. Nothing too fancy. I'm not painting it in that well. Just indicate something like that. So we got some windows. And that's all. I think I made these windows slightly narrower than those others, the other picture, but... Okay, so there we go. So that's that. Now what happens? Now what could we do? Well, say while this is drying, meanwhile back at the ranch, while this is drying, we can do one of these pot shapes. And you guys remember our pot shape, yeah? So
you laid that right on top of your painting.
Here's a pot. Yeah, it's got a thing here. It's got a
just make me so nervous what you did.
Here's a pot.
Hey, let's thank Cheryl for a donation, a very healthy donation, and we do definitely appreciate that.
Cheryl, thank you so much. I so appreciate it. You can't know. This really helps us. You know, there's a lot of artists on YouTube that are very fortunate to have made fantastic deals with different manufacturers and get all kinds of free stuff. We go down to Michael's just like the rest of you guys and buy it, so we appreciate it very much. All right, so you see that's my pot shape. You saw that, right? Now, so I know that I don't want to come up. Here's the top of my railing. I want to come up about halfway with a pot here, okay, and one over here, kind of on this end, okay? So we got two pots, okay? That's good. So what are we going to do? We're going to take a little bit of yellow, a little cad red medium, make a little bright orange color, a little more red maybe, and now that we've established our pot shape, let's just put in a pot, which is really simple. This is sort of Ginger's basic pots that go in everything. If you've done our village pieces, if you've seen pots, if you've done our little pots of flowers, this is basically the pot that goes in everything. I have a lantern that I like, and I like this pot, so there's no sense in coming up with another pot. This one seems to work fine. Now there has to be a light source for the pot, so let's see. A little bit of burnt sienna. We'll make a little bit darker light source. We're saying the light's kind of coming off from the left. So, I mean, that's my plan. So let's take a little bit of burnt sienna, maybe a little bit of ultramarine blue, a little bit of burnt sienna. And let's see, do we want a little bit of a lip on this pot? Let's take a little cad red medium with that. There we go. So more of a reddish color. Let's say here's this edge of the pot.
Donna wants to know, why would you paint the sky inside the house? Isn't the balcony outside the window?
No, this is the reflection of the window.
Just wait
till
it's
done.
This
is the reflection of the window. You're not painting the you're not painting the sky in front of the house. You're painting the balcony is actually reflecting the window is actually reflecting it's the glass reflecting the sky. Okay? You know, which is why you've got it kind of darker in the corners, okay? So, now that being said, let's make it a little bit brighter on the outside here. There we go. Here's pots, okay? So we've got two pots. I'm just trying to think of what we can do to... Now I'm going to come up here and lighten this again because that was a little wet. Come down here like that. All right, so... Now, at this point, probably I need to dry something, but what else could I do? Well, I've got a little bit of water, a little bit of burnt sienna. I could come under here like this and a little bit more water on the brush, and I could create a little bit of a... shadow down underneath here like this, okay, just kind of underneath my little bit more water on it, maybe just wipe some of it off like that, make it more of a like a tea stain. So down here I want a little shadow, okay, and as long as I was doing that, okay, now that I'm kind of happy with this, I could come up here like this with a little bit of water and burnt sienna and make some drippy stuff coming down off the sides here like this. Let's take a little bit of the buff titanium and come back in here like this. And this is our second coat of buff titanium. Maybe we want a little bit brighter in here, okay? And now I know where everything's going to be. I kind of know where I want some lighter stuff, okay? I want something kind of light around where these pots are going. And let's see, a little bit of drippy stuff coming down this way. So this is like your second coat. Now, could you have used stucco on here? Absolutely, could have used stucco. And we've got a great video on stucco. That's in the hall, John. You want to grab that? I'll show that one, because that's on YouTube if you haven't seen that one on how to do this whole thing in stucco, gels. Yeah, then you would make this whole thing just what I'm telling you, except that it would take you longer because you're going to do stucco, right?
Here's a question from Shannon. Okay. Should new artists try all different types of genres or just zero in on one?
Well, I tell you what, it's like, years ago when I went to school in Switzerland, I was taking French, and then I had the stupid idea I'd take Spanish at the same time, and then I couldn't speak anything, okay? So pick something. I don't care whether it's airbrushing or watercolor or acrylics, but stick with that, okay? Pick something, learn that. If I had to take up oil painting, it's completely, you'll see a lot of oil painting artists, and they will, there's a little bit of burnt umber coming down here from the top too, kind of darkened up the corners. Sometimes you'll see oil painting artists, and they'll paint with acrylics the same way they do oil paints. And I've said this before, it is a long, convoluted way to go about it. But, you know, I've been lucky enough to have just spent my whole, art career painting with acrylics. Okay, I want this pretty light to here like that. Okay. Okay. Yeah, here's what we're talking about. Here's something similar. Do you see what we're talking about? This is a YouTube video where we used real stucco. Can you see the texture on it? And we did the windows. Again, you see the light reflecting in the windows off the glass. Here's where it isn't, okay? So, and the bricks and everything, and we just did a few flowers, all right? And we did this with the raised gels. Now, you could do this painting the same way, all right? Which is absolutely cool as can be, all right? So, let's... I just want to say that is an absolute nifty thing to be able to do. I'm going to take a little yellow on this pot, maybe a little yellow oxide. Need a little bit lighter right there. Not quite that light. So we just mix that in with the paint here. Mix that in here.
Thank you, Donna, for the donation. Greatly appreciate that.
Oh, gosh, you guys, you're being so nice. Thank you very much. We really appreciate it. Okay, yeah, I guess we wanted this side lighter, too. Got a little confused here. This side's lighter, that side's darker. Okay, got it.
Ginger, are there other books you'd recommend?
Yeah, there's one I really like. Acrylic, it's called Drawing Secrets or something. I have, on my Pinterest page, I have books that I like. And that's one. It's really about composition. And I can't say enough about it because, you know, composition, somebody sent me a painting just today and that they'd made up. They didn't have a reference. They just made it up out of their head. Well, you know, that only goes so far, and guess what? Then it doesn't go at all, you guys, because there's too many elements involved in making up a picture that if you know, there's design elements. Every line means something. Just like, making up a story and not in a foreign language and not speaking the language, you know, you can say anything, right? I can't believe I said that, you know? Yeah, and that's... And I'm a firm believer in, you know, you can make up your own painting, but if you're going to paint a flower, have a picture of a flower. If you're going to paint a house, have some reference photos if you have to put it together. And so that one book really explains design, some simple ways. So you can get a couple of designs then you're good to make up stuff. Because not every photograph that we've talked about makes a good painting. For instance, one of the things that people love to do every calendar year is they love to take... what is that wilderness area of Sierra Club calendars and paint them. And you'll see where the photographer's got that rushing water. It's going really, really fast over the waterfall and kind of how, what is that called when they shoot it like that?
Slow shutter speed makes it smooth.
Yeah, okay, well, if you painted it, it's great for photo, horrible for painting. But that's your reference, so you don't necessarily want that. Okay.
Wait.
I got to dry something real quick.
I know you do.
Ah.
The stucco painting you were talking about, is that on YouTube?
Yes, this stucco painting is on YouTube, you guys. This is on YouTube. We'll put up an iCard later for this, all right? This is on YouTube. How to do this. This is a cool painting. It's in two parts on how to do this. I mean, we have so many great videos that are just, they disappear in the feed. This is one of the things that just absolutely bugs me. This is on there. Here's one of my favorite ones. Look at this one. This is the garden gate. Nobody sees this. This
it's
is a fantastic little video, okay? This is darling, full-length video on YouTube. Nobody sees these things. I don't know what happens to them. They just disappear, and nobody sees them.
Because we're getting too much content.
Well, John thinks we just have far too much content. I think they just get lost in the feed because they aren't advertised. If you like the garden gate picture, then you can go over to our website. And again, we're talking about a painting with flowers. You're going to show, you know, this flower, if you do these on YouTube, right, the ones I'm talking about, this video will not be a challenge for you. Okay, and you can actually buy this as a single video. You can rent it for $4.95, or you can buy it as a single video and own it and download it. I mean, then that's in our store. You don't have to become a monthly. We have a lot of videos just for our month, you know, that you can get. And if you're a monthly subscriber, you get a discount off of all that. I don't think you get it off the rentals, but you get it off everything else.
Right, not the rentals.
Not the rentals. Okay, so I'm going to dry this, you guys. But this is just cool, and I've got others to show you, too. We are the flower queens here, all right? So I'm going to dry
kings
this real quick.
Kings and queens, please.
All
right, so while she's drying that, yeah, I think Wendy found the stucco link there for you. I was going to try to look it up. I think she's got it right there. That's a great little lesson if you want to add stucco to this wall. We do appreciate that, Wendy, being right on top of the ball. I'm sorry I haven't been able to find a way to quiet her down, her hair dryer while this is going on, but we'll work on that. Does Ginger have available a painting of with a waterfall in it?
Yeah, in our Wave and Water class, I've got three or four of them. Three or four waterfall paintings. Okay, so let's put a few tapes going this way. All right, let's go across this way now. And let's just do a cross piece. Someone says one way you can not measure is to make sure you have a perfect square here, like a perfect corner, like this line and this line. That looks pretty straight to me. I can double check it, but I think it is. Okay. And let's find the bottom part of this tape. We're going to put the cross pieces in, and then we're going to also put the balcony in. Okay, like this. Let's see. I think I can do this like this. Just like this. That's all we need, right? Like that. And you can do really thin lines like that, too. Okay. So then I want to come down about 1, 2, and do one here. Let me put my balcony in, too, and then I'll know where I want the other one. Let me put my glasses on because I've got this drawn in here if I can see it. Okay, here we go. This is where my balcony is. Like that. Let me just move all this out of the way. Where'd the triangle go? Ah, oh, that's the big one. Where'd the little one go? Ah, here it is. Okay, I just want to make sure I have this. That won't help me. Why will that not help me? All right, like this. Okay, yeah, okay. So, and then this is going to here. Okay, so this has got to go, this is going to go up and down to here at some point. This is where this one stops. And we've got really some great flower paintings on YouTube and on our website, really. And I know people like to paint them, and it's really kind of cool. While I'm taping this, John, let's do another trivia one. Where'd our die go?
Ooh.
We're dying for the die. All right, another
dying
trivia.
For the
here
die.
We go. All right.
Six again. That's my girl. Going for the mysteries today.
Mystery questions. All right, so here's, I'm going to say that this is our, that's not long enough. I'm going to say this is our, where are we putting this railing? Oh, it's up here. Okay, so this is our railing up here like this. Okay. All right, that's the railing.
Let's, all right, here we go. Multiple choice for you. I'll do the best with their names.
Change this one then. Okay, I'm going to change that one. And put it like this. And then we'll do another one here and put it like that. What's our multi-question?
Multi-question. Which painter said, "I can't stand dirty flies. I only like the clean ones."
Dirty flies, I only like the clean ones?
I only like the clean ones.
Somebody said that?
Somebody actually said that.
And they quoted him 100 years later?
Well, I'm not sure how old this gentleman is.
You know, I mean, gosh.
Salvador Dali. Francisco de Goya. Goya? G-O-Y-A?
Goya, he was a Spanish painter. Yeah, Goya. Okay.
Diego
Velasquez. Velasquez.
Yep.
Those are all Spanish paint. Implies there's a lot of flies in Spain, doesn't it? Those are all.
Do we have any folks out there from Spain? Do you have a lot of flies over there? Are they clean flies or dirty flies? So we want to know what you think.
A little bit of dark color here for
Dali,
the railing.
Dali, Gora, Goa. Goa, was it?
Goya.
Goya. And
Velasquez.
Velasquez. One of those.
And Dali.
Flies, no flies.
Salvador Dali. Salvador Dali.
Yep. Salvador Dali, Francisco.
Now you think about it, they all lived in different time periods, okay?
Oh, so you think the flies got dirtier as time went on, or
well, I don't know.
I don't either.
I'm just stopping here at the center here, like this. Make sure I should have probably made a stop here with the tape. I have to guess where the stop is here for this.
What part are you putting in there now?
I'm putting in the cross pieces.
Oh, okay.
And to this, the side pieces here, the little cross pieces.
Yeah, I got you now.
And I'm putting in the top bar. For the
Dali, 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 Dali.
Everybody
Dali.
Thinks it's Dali. It's
Everybody's
interesting why
Dali.
They think it's Dali, and I would think that you know, if you think about it, Goya was the Velasquez was the oldest one.
Was he the guy that you did the horse from?
Yeah, was okay. The guy we did the horse from. I'm saying Velasquez. I don't know if that's true or not, but I'm saying Velasquez. He was the oldest guy.
Well, people that said, Dali, you're the winner. You have stumped the artist today.
Oh, boy, stumped the artist. Wow, that's great. So shout out some names. Who stumped the artist, John?
We've had Ivan did
Ivan?
Denise, Anna Marie.
Anna Marie.
Couponing with Jenny.
Wow, you guys.
Dorothy stumped
it.
Out of the UK.
Wow.
Lori Cass said they're all dirty.
Well, you know, that's we had our little bout with flies this year, didn't we, John?
Oh, we did.
We had our little bout with flies, and
we won.
John got the vacuum cleaner out and vacuumed them up. You're going, how many flies did you have?
Oh, you don't want to know.
Like 1,000 flies. We had a dead something in the walls, and then they all hatched out of that, like some. You know, and then one day there was no flies, and then suddenly in the bathroom was like 6 million flies in the bathroom. I'm going, John, help! There's flies. We're being Lord of the Flies has taken over the bathroom. So then he got a vacuum cleaner and vacuumed it. He says, "No worry, I've got it." Something like that. Very, very impressed, John. All right, I'm going to dry this real quick, and then we're going to put the side rails on.
Boy, you got to be quick on that button today. She's going back and forth. I hope the sound's coming out okay. Am I too loud? Am I okay? And she's back.
Yeah. So anyway, I'm a little off on this, but you got to go with me. This was all done kind of late, but you can imagine. All right. So we got a rail here, and we got a rail here. You're not really going to see these, but I'm going to put them in anyway. They're all going to get covered up. This is why I wasn't that. I got less persnickety the second time about it because all these were going to get covered up, right?
Right.
All right. So here we go. There's that and brush. What do we do with the brush? Yeah. So remember, if you've had brush in water, you know, make sure you've dried it off on a rag or something. All right, so we're going to say here's our top pieces with the rail, like here, like that. Now the others we're going to do by hand. We're only taping the outside ones, and again, you're not really going to see it. Okay? But we've got them taped in here just for the sake of it, okay? But this is... basically, somebody says, how long does it take you to do a big street scene, you know, with lots of windows, say something like this, right? This is really a neat one. It's one of the ones on our website. And again, you've got all these windows and doors and everything. And then this is all done with all kinds of texture on this. Like, I don't know how many videos are in this one.
Tip that a little bit. See if we can see the texture at all.
Can you see the texture? Can you see? Can you
yeah,
see
you
how thick it is?
Yeah, go the other way. Yeah, like there. There you go.
Can you see the texture on it?
Yeah.
Like that. You can really see it, can't you?
Yeah.
And look at this neat light source across the door. This is a really fun video. That's over on gingercooklive.gallery too. Okay. So as long as I've got these dark colors out, now I'm going to come along the inside of this, and let's just take a rag, and pinch the brush. If you've been using the brush to mix colors. Just get it on one side. Let me put my glasses on so I could possibly see what I was doing. Just get it on one side like that, and we're going to make a little shadow right there. And under here like this. Wherever there's a light, there's a dark. And sometimes these little tiny little gestures of color can make such a difference, because when we get, you can straighten some stuff out too if you got a little carried away. Again, you could you can tape everything, but you don't really have to. And I want to say there's just on the underside, not the top side of this, but the underside. And I'm going to just say that I've got some shutters going this way at an angle. Just using an angle and using my little tiny knife blade of a brush, I'm just going to follow the angle of that we've already got here, following this angle. They're not going straight across because they're following this diagonal and this one, like that. And just suggesting there was some shutters going down. You're really not going to see it past the railing. All right, that's about the most you're going to see. And then you might see a little bit of, say, buff titanium, or, you know, some sort of light color, doesn't really matter. It's on the top of the rails, there's usually some, and I'm putting this in by hand, even though we taped the other. Let's take a little white in that here. I'm putting this in by hand on top of these, like that, so they don't look so taped. I think it's really easy to get that sort of tape look. And let's do the same thing on top of our railing here, too.
Looks too artificial.
Yeah, it does. It just gets, this, yeah. So you've got, your tape sort of helps you keep things straight, and then you kind of bung it up a little bit like this. And then everybody goes, oh, I can't believe you painted that straight line. That's so cool. Okay, so now you're going, okay, so then what happens? Well, we take a little bit of white paint, okay? And this is so fun. Come on, don't you think this is fun? Take a little white paint, and you're going to come right here, and you're going to make a little, like the letter U, like that, little pot. See, pot, little small pot right here, okay? Little bigger pot here on the edge. Then we'll do one over here because, we, you know, over here, let's draw a little piece of chalk. Let's get another piece of chalk so you can see it. Can you see this one? No? Well, you can see this brown one. Ah, all right, so here's another little, up on the railing here is another, and let's do a light one here. Here's another little, make the top one a little bit taller. This one's going to be a little bigger, and this one's going to be a little bit smaller. All right, so you've got two little pots, okay? So you take some white paint and just paint those in. And if you're painting over any kind of chalk, remember, if it's brown chalk, then it's going to be kind of an off-white because you're going to pick up the color of the chalk and dye the paint. That's all right. We're not going to leave it white. We're just going to say here's our first two pots. Okay, there's a couple pots. And then we'll come over here and do the same thing. And don't worry about them getting them exactly the same size. Just try to have the one on the far left be a little bit taller. So again, here's some white paint. Here's another little pot like this, a little smaller. Okay, sitting on top of our railing. Okay, so far so good? Everybody's with me? Yeah?
Oh, I have to say they are.
All right.
They're painting right along.
All right, so there we go. This isn't tricky. It's a little tedious. It's not necessarily tricky. You know, there's a big difference between tedious and tricky. I'd say huge, personally, okay? Big difference. All right, so now we're going to just rinse the brush because we've done that. Okay, so what we want to do now is our next job is to, oh, I don't know. Let's take a little bit of this dark brown paint. Let's do a little bit of ribbing under here like that on each pot. We could do that. Now, burnt umber, ultramarine blue, burnt umber, tiny bit of yellow, a little bit of phthalo blue, dark green. See my dark green?
Yeah, I've been there. I've done that one.
Okay. Let's add a little bit of purple to it. Dark green, really dark green, a little more blue, okay? Almost black, but it's green. Now, what we're going to do, because we've dried everything, okay, is we're going to take some tape. Oh, well, we haven't dried these pots. Let's dry these pots, and then we're good, okay? All right.
Save as.
Dry with the pots, right?
Well, I grabbed mine. I hope I didn't mess up my microphone. So April's chewing on her cud in the camera. That's good. So she hadn't had her baby yet. What's the hold up, people?
Okay, so we dried those.
You're back.
And I'm telling you what, do you have Christine's dogs you can show? Those were good. All right, let's put a little piece of tape right here.
No, I don't. How'd you send those to me?
I just emailed them to you.
Let me go see if I can grab those while we're...
She just, Christine, our friend in UK, she sent us the picture of her dog, and then just took me to see it, and I just felt compelled to just give her a couple suggestions, and so she sent them back. Okay, this is what we're going to do here. Corner brush, we're going to start tapping in a plant back here, like this. And the reason we tape this is because we don't want to go over the shutters. Now, the trick is to make this outside edge very uneven. And tiny little dots, like little escaped plant things, going this way. Now we're going to go on top of our pot here, and we want to come away from here, like this, on the side, like that. Little tiny dots. You can use a tinier brush if you need to, but this is our first line of defense. With the that's
whoa,
the behind our shutter. Now coming down here, under on the top of this pot, same color. Okay. Now, we're just going to come down around here like this. We're going to go in front of this railing, you know, in a couple places.
Spicy Silver Lady has a question for you.
Hi, Kate. All right.
Spicy Silver Lady.
Okay. Hi. Love all it. Right.
If you are a member, is there a limit of paintings per month you can submit for help?
No, there really isn't. We haven't done that yet. We probably should, but we haven't. But the thing is that, you know, I will send back corrections. If you send me something, I'll send back some suggestions. Sometimes it's just one or two things. Sometimes it's a bigger thing. Sometimes it's just, gosh, you nailed it. You want to hear someone tell you you did great, right? Some of you guys really nail these things. You're all getting snarkily good, I tell you what. But snarkily good. You
like snarkily
that?
Good.
But anyway, let's just put a few little snagglies down here like this, something behind
some
the pot.
Some snagglies to go with the snarkilies.
To go with the snarklies. Now we're coming along here. I want to leave a little bit of a loop right in here, okay, right in here where the railing's going to be. So right now we're just going to bring in some greenery.
Now, this may appear black to you. It is not. It's a very, very
dark,
deep
dark,
green.
Dark green. Very dark green, okay?
Very deep.
Very deep green. It's our darkest green. We're going to come along here like this. And then in this part, let's just come over the railing here like this with some dark green and little tiny plants coming off this way. A few little dots of there, like that. And then let's come back over to this plant. See, I wasn't worried. See, this is why I wasn't all too excited about the bottom of our pots here, because I knew all this was going to get covered. That's why I wasn't being all that particular. Sometimes when you know what the outcome of something, then you get less excited about what happens. And let's come back here to our railing, like this, and then come out this way with it and say there's some...
Robin said in the past you said there was four. What was four? There was something we did four for, but it wasn't the lessons.
For what?
When we were talking about the sending in art for art critiques. We had a four limit on something a long time ago for something else.
Well, you can send in three at a time, and you can send in one original painting once a month. In other words, and I want to see... Okay, back and forth. All right,
where
see how I'm coming out here from the side and maybe say something coming down this way?
I don't get that. I don't know what that does.
All right, so we're coming down that way. Everybody's kind of there. And then we've got something on the top of these little flower pots, okay? And then maybe a few little...
Hang in there. We don't know what's going on with the
something
feed,
over the railing here. Okay, like that. Something over the railing here. Now let's come over to this side and say something's over the railing on these pots. Like this, and then on the top of this one, and then out this way, maybe going up into the window. Okay, so you guys are going, wow, isn't that cool? I'm going, wow, isn't that cool? I just do it myself. I'm going, isn't that pretty? I wish I could grow plants like this. So yeah, at this point we haven't, but you know, if you rush through them, here's what I would say, you won't get as much out of the lessons if you just rush through them. We suggest, you know, do whatever you want. There's like 292, 97, something like that, incredible videos up there, so you're not going to do them all. And we have that many, not because we think you should do them all, but if you'll, here's the thing, there's an order of four in this sense, is that get the basics. Even if you already painted in oil or watercolor, do our basic one cookie lessons, two cookie lessons. Understand the brushstrokes that I've developed. Went back when nobody was painting acrylics, and whenever they did have a book with acrylics, it was all how to get a watercolor effect. So a lot of the things I teach you, no one else is going to show you. Cinnamon might, because she's taking lessons from me, but no one else really is going to show you how to do it, because this is sort of... unique to me in the way I explain how to do stuff, but you will speed up your journey. And I can give you, I have a good friend, and she's been taking art lessons from me for seven years. And really, when you take an art lesson from me, you can do it any way you want. I will make a suggestion, and you know, if you want to do something else, listen, it's your dime, kids. You know, it's just whatever. But I had, you know, usually about, you know, 12 people in a class, you know, 6 to 12 people. And this one friend, she still comes, right? She insisted on doing it her way, okay? And she still, even though she paints beautifully, by this time she should never have to ask me anything, ever. And she still does, because she didn't do the basics. She didn't do the basics, and so she did. So when it comes to a new thing, she doesn't know how to go back and fix it. Those basics, it's not whether you could ever would want to draw a penguin in your life, but there's some brush techniques in that video. There's some techniques in these videos. Honestly, Andrew, our good friend Andrew, sent us a painting today. He never even saw. He's been with us a little over a year and a half.
I remember the first ones.
And he's gotten so good that it's scary. He watched our RAS, Reality Art Show, with the tangerines, and he sent me a picture today of his. Do you have that? It's on Pinterest. Do you have that? No? He's looking at me. No. We'll show you tomorrow night, okay? We'll show you tomorrow night. We'll show you Andrew's. It's fantastic. And he didn't even have a lesson with it. He just watched it on the Reality Art Show because he knows all the steps. And then he sent it in for a little tiny bit of help, and I just made one little teeny suggestion on it. But it was absolutely fantastic. Best thing he's ever done. Okay? And that's because, you know, there's some real benefit. So, yeah, you can send it in, but, you know, try to get these. And let's put a few little in front of this pot like that. There you go. Okay? Like that. Down over there. Okay. So now what you do, okay, is now we're going to take some yellow and add to that, and a little white and add to that. Okay? A little bit of yellow, a little bit of white. Now we've got this light green color. Now what are we going to do with it? Light's coming from the top. Okay? So we're going to tap on, just using the corner of our brush, light's coming from the top, some light, little bits of light green. Ooh, isn't this fun? Like that, light. The light green's gonna be on the top, not just anywhere like freckles. Okay, we're gonna say there's some light green in here, maybe up in here like this. We're gonna come down here and say that there's a little light green maybe coming, you know, this way from the window, little dots of little clumps of leaves like that. Come down here like this, tap in a little of this light green color.
Oh, this is still wet on wet.
Still wet on wet, so it's going to be a little darker than I intend, but it's just poke a hole in here. Now I'm going to get a little more paint, a little yellow oxide mixed to that, change the greens over here. And on this side, I'm going to just say that there's some real pretty light green stuff that's growing this way over here. Now how about here? Maybe we want a little bit up here like this. We haven't put the flowers in yet. Probably looking kind of cute though, right? A few little dots, little odd little escapees. Little leaves that are escaping. Think about little leaves that are escaping like that. Okay.
Escapees.
Now. Okay, so at this point, you can back out. Isn't this cute?
I am.
We haven't even done anything, but there you go.
What have you been doing for the last hour?
Well, I mean, we have, but I mean, you when you think about it, right? I mean, we haven't planted any flowers now, but you can see where we've got some, you know, we've done fairly well here. Now, let's rinse the brush.
Donna has a question.
Sure, and I'm going to take a little more white paint and kind of repaint this, okay? Okay, yeah, question, Donna? Yeah, love the questions.
Yeah, you're going to love this one. What is one of the worst things you have had a student of yours paint?
Oh gosh, this gal, she came to me. She hadn't taken lessons yet. She came to me and she brought this painting. She had no reference for it. She had brought this painting. And I was looking at it going, huh. Because I always try to find something, you know, you can always find something nice to say about anything, you know, if you look hard enough, you know. Here's a little bit of white in our windows too, for those of you who are wondering how this was working. Kind of indicate glass here. And she says, give me your first thought on this. And you know what my first thought was? Fire.
Fire. Fire sale.
Just burn it, you know? Light a fire and burn it. Don't try to paint over it. Just light a fire and burn it. There was no hope for that because I know she was painting, but at this point it was just black it out and start again. You know, that's okay. We all have those days. You got to be willing. It's mostly you can, I love acrylics because you really can't get it too wrong. Because of that. All right, so we're going to come up here like this, going using our angle brush, and I'm just going to create using that little tiny bit of water on the tip of the brush, a little bit of purple, a little bit of burnt umber. Wipe the brush, make sure it's nice and skinny, holding it straight up like a knife blade.
Ooh. Wendy went out and found Andrew's painting on Pinterest.
Oh, did she?
She is so good.
Thank you, Wendy. Well, it's really good. I mean, I put it on Pinterest. It's excellent, you guys.
And
it
you
is
did
excellent.
This from the fly on the wall episode. Yeah, we had two people do it so far that way.
Yeah, and they've done a wonderful job. See,
so
what,
I'm not even going to bother putting the lesson up.
Well, did she show everybody? She can't show everybody.
No, but she put the link there.
Okay, but I mean, he did really good, you see? And he did great. Okay, now let's take a little blue here, a little bit of ultramarine blue and a little bit of brown. Make a little shadowy color, okay, like that. And we'll say on this side of the pot, a little bit of white with it. On this side of the pot, it's a little bit darker, see, like that. We're going to say this side of the pot, see, a little darker, a little bit darker than I wanted. Here we go. All right, so we're going to say the kind of the right side of the pot's got a little bit bluer, so it's a little shadow. Like that. There you go. You can't just have a white pot, have a shadow. Okay. Now we've got the rails. Now you see there? There's our rails. Now look what we're painting here. Now, how much harder is it going to be to put the flowers in?
Oh, now we're down to the easy part.
Yeah, so then you have to decide. Now I'm going to show you why I decided this. I've got purple here. So I put yellow here because yellow is the complement of purple. Purple and blue were kind of next, you know, near each other on the color wheel, so those kind of went nicely here. I came up in this part and separated and put some orange and magenta flowers. Then I came over here and I've got some white ones and some more pink ones and some pink ones over here. So these pink ones are kind of in a triangle that balance. These white ones balance with this. I mean, there was sort of some thought to how I put the flowers. And, so the thing I'm going to do real quick, John, do you have anything you can show or shall I roll the dice while I'm drawing?
No. As a matter of fact, we have... One moment, please. Please stand by.
So, can I draw something?
No, we don't. I didn't get that far.
All right, I'm gonna draw a dice.
You're gonna draw a dice.
It's five.
Oh, you know, when it falls on an edge,
it's facing
a rollover. It's a rollover.
It's a one.
Ugh.
It's a one. It rolled over. Nobody saw it though. How will they know it's a one?
Oh, I don't believe you. I didn't see it.
Do you want me to do it again in front of the camera?
I gotta see it in the camera.
It's three. A 3.
All
okay,
right.
Now we go. All right.
Okay, I got to look up a 3. A 3 is a win. I'm sorry, guys. I didn't get the pictures up ready to show you. Mondays are just hectic. And we do want to remind everybody that we will no longer be doing Wednesdays at the end of April. Wednesday nights will be gone. We'll wait for... Ginger to come back so she can get the question too. It's going to be a Leonardo da Vinci question. So there you go.
What's the question?
Oh, I'm sorry. I already asked the question.
Well, I want to know what the question is.
I'm sorry. What's the answer?
Well, what was the question?
I can't tell you. It's already been said once.
Oh, okay. All right.
No, I told him I was going to wait for you.
Okay. What is the question?
The question is... How old was Leonardo da Vinci when he crossed the Alps on a mule's back to come to the French court in 1516?
Leonardo da Vinci?
Do you know him?
Crossed the Alps on a mule to go to the French court from Italy.
In 1516.
Oh, man, I'm telling you what a journey. I have been... The Swiss and now the Italians, those Italians guys, they're so crazy. They've got some roads up there that cross the Alps. And in a car, and you try to imagine doing it in the wintertime, those are some scary mountains. This poor man did it on a donkey, a mule. Oh, my gosh.
I don't know how old he was.
I'll tell you what he had to be. He had to be young enough to be crazy.
Okay.
This is the kind of stupid thing young people do. All right.
I've got to give you a choice of 3 years.
Okay.
23 years old.
Uh-huh.
42 years old.
Okay.
Or 64 years old.
Okay.
And this was Leonardo da Vinci crossing the Alps on the mule's back to come to the French court in 1516.
All right, and please notice I'm doing some white because yellow only paints over white.
We have 17, wild guess, 17, 20s. We had one say 64. So sad.
Got a little bit of white up here because I want some of these flowers to show up a little better, a little
54.
Bit brighter.
54, I assume that was a 64. 25, 24.
Okay.
23, 23, 64, 23, 23.
Well, give some names. Who said 63? Who are these people that are talking to us, John? They'd love to hear their names.
Big Sweet Potato said 64.
Okay.
Maureen said 64. Sue Lynn says 23. Steffi Cake says 23. Dorothy says 64. Couponing with Jenny is 23. Christopher is 64. Sylvia is 23. Sue Clark's 23. Denise is 64.
All right, now what's the answer?
42. Well, what's Ginger say?
Well, I'm going to say that that sounds like something a young, stupid person would do. So I'm going to say that Jen is 20s, you know? Okay?
64.
Wow.
He's my kind of guy.
I'm telling you what. I said so. Wow. Really?
He was 64 when he did that foolish trek.
Wow, that is really, that's brave, man. That's some hostile stuff. Of course, he probably did it in the summer, but still. If that's, you know, they didn't have great roads back then. That was a deal. You know, you get in a car right now and you can't do a road trip without Cheetos. You know what I mean?
Well, yes, you can. No Cheetos in Patty. Ain't going to happen.
What? Everybody knows that Cheetos are the quintessential road trip food.
I don't think so. Okay, people, we're taking a survey. What is your favorite road trip food? You're going to go on a long journey. What's the food you take of choice? Now, going back to our Wednesdays, we are going to stop Wednesdays after the 29th of April.
Yep.
We can't do four live shows.
Because we've been doing painting with John, and we can't get anything else done. Okay, so we're going to go, while this white's drying, we're going to take some dazzling purple and a little ultramarine blue and kind of mix them together, okay? Like that, a little tiny bit of white with them, but not much, okay? Just
that
sort of a dark purple color.
Yeah, pretty.
And I'm going to just darken some purple flowers here, like this, in this kind of dark green, over this dark green little cluster of stuff, okay? So I'm going to say, here's my little purple flowers.
Cheetos, Doritos, beef jerky.
Beef jerky, that's a good one. Beef jerky.
Pretzels.
Yeah.
Coffee, trail mix, potatoes, potato chips.
Potato chips, yeah.
Pork rinds, sweet tarts.
Sweet
donuts,
tarts.
Coffee, jerky, mixed nuts, fruits. Cheetos and Diet Coke. It was a combination for me.
Cheetos. But the Cheetos are the food of the gods. Bits, you know what I'm saying? Then what? You know, they're
chips.
Their own food group. No one else. Yes. Okay. I'm sorry if you
hot
guys
tamales.
In England don't know that. I would send you some.
Hot tamales. Chocolate cherries. What's Ginger's daughter's name? Cinnamon. Slim Jims. Totally Diet Coke. Jelly beans.
Okay.
Lemon Oreos.
Lemon Oreos. I've tried
those.
Those sound good. Those sounds pretty good.
Mine is chocolate and the hubby's is Cheetos.
Okay, so now I'm going to start with some pink flowers, right? So I'm going to go right on top of this white, like that.
Oh, I like that.
See, and you see how they're a little bit brighter because I went on top of the white?
I'm going to zoom in on
that's
that.
That's the magenta going right on top of the white.
It's really a must-have color if you're going to be doing flowers.
Yeah, your magenta is one of the things. Somebody says quadrichrome or some. I don't care. Just pick a magenta and grab it. It doesn't really matter. You know, just don't get all that fussy with it. We're just tapping these on here to see like this. We're saying, here's some flowers. And if I leave some of the white showing, that's okay, because that'll just act like a highlight. So don't panic. You don't have to cover every last little bit of the white. You know you're going to have some white right
popcorn
here.
Popcorn and raisinettes.
Oh, yeah, popcorn. John had never had raisinettes, chocolate-covered raisins. But then if you haven't had Costco chocolate-covered raisins, they are obviously wonderful. Now, here's a little white and magenta at the same time for these tiny little roses growing up here like that. I'm going to say it's a different kind of flower in here like this. See, a little bit more.
PB&J. Now, there's somebody who knows what they're talking about.
Peanut butter and jelly, in case somebody doesn't know it. Okay.
Everybody knows what PB&J is.
Not everybody. Listen, you've got some people from the UK, from Australia. They may not know.
Oh, PB&J is international.
I don't know that it is.
I'm craving Cheetos now.
All right.
Blame Ginger on that one.
Okay, so now I'm going to take a little white and purple, right, like that. And I'm going to come up here to the top of these, and I'm going to remember the same thing with the leaves. The top part of the flower is light, and the dark purple's underneath. So
which,
just the way we did the leaves, we're doing that with the purple.
Which brush are you using? You're still in the
3/8? This is a quarter inch.
Quarter inch angle,
because I want a little tinier, like this. And the same thing over here, I'm just going to say that this is down here like that. Okay, so those are those. Now, I want some blue and white ones. I'm going to take some ultramarine blue and white. And these in here are a little different. So this one in here, it's blue, but they're kind of coming down in front of this pot like this, kind of drooping off this like that. And then I'll put a little white on top of those. See? Now right into the white paint while this is still wet. Okay, let me wake that white paint up. Drop a little tiny, remember, just on the top now of this, and because it's still wet, it'll be sort of an off blue color.
Things are out of me again.
And you want ultramarine blue red shade, not ultramarine blue green shade, all right? So those are those little flowers, and let's take a little more blue and darken up a couple places, just some dark blue, just pure dark blue, like that, okay? So just make a little contrast here. Okay, so there's those blue flowers. You guys, is this pretty? Now this was not hard to do. I mean, I think this is great. Now we got to get some yellow. So we're going to get...
Hold on a second.
Yellow oxide, yeah?
Is the design magenta more opaque than the Quinn magenta?
You know, I have no idea. You want to see? Here's some Quinn magenta. Let's see. I have no idea.
Would you have the design magenta?
I've got them both. This is design, that's Quinn.
Well, wait a minute. Let me get over your palette.
So, where's my tablet? Let's look. That's a good question. That is a good question.
Whoa, question of the night has been awarded to...
Two. Question of the night is a really good question. Who?
J-I-R-U-P. Jerp, jerp.
Jerp, jerp. Jerp, jerp. That is a good...
That's what I'm saying it is.
Jerp, 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 jerp. Yeah, that is a great question. Jerp, what you have won is either a free download from gingercooklive.gallery or 7 days worth of art lessons on our website. Just email us and tell us your contact information.
Use our contact us form.
Contact us form, all right? Now, so the question was, which is different? So here's some white canvas, right? So here's the... This is design magenta like this.
That's a pretty color.
That's pretty, right? Now, here's another brush, clean brush. Okay, here's this color.
Ooh, I like that one better.
This is quadricum. It's a little...
Pinker.
Pinker, isn't it?
It looks more transparent, too.
Yeah, so now, yeah, it does look more transparent. Okay, now, because I just never thought to ask that. Now let's take some white, right?
Wait, there's still more.
Here's some white. Let's take some white with us, see what the white does. Because this is what this looks like when you've got white with it, like this, right? Here's some white with this, right? And then here's this with white. What does that look like? All right, this is what this looks like when the white's pretty. It's more, this is a little more purple.
Yeah.
When white's added to it, and this is a little pinker. Interesting. But this is definitely more of a shocking pink, isn't it? This has more of a red.
More of a shocking pink. It looks more transparent.
Yeah, so I guess it would depend on... Good question. Wow, we all learned something today.
The day has not been wasted. Thanks again for joining us. We've learned our lesson for the day, and we're done. Bye.
Yeah, okay, so now we're going back over here. We're doing the dark yellow. So now we're going to go back over to the yellow oxide, which is our dark bottom of the flower color, right, like that?
Bottom of the flower.
That's our darkest color on the yellow flowers. You got to have, even yellow has to have a dark color, okay? Now we're going to take a little bit of white and... See if I think I'm out of white. Let's just start white in a new place here because you don't want it contaminated, and a little bit of light yellow, okay? Now, we're going to come on top of this like this. Now, where's our light yellow going? On the, right over the white, on the top, over that, and the yellow oxide's kind of underneath. That's your shadow color underneath. And if you got carried away, you can come back with a little yellow oxide and add a bit more shadow color if you need to, somewhere like that. You want the shadow color kind of underneath. And then what I want to do is take some phthalo blue and yellow and make a bright green color. That's the green. And then take a little bit of that beige color with it. Look at that, see? That's a buff titanium. So we kind of, now let's take a little bit of that color and add some little light green leaves and some of this. Break that shape up. Just a little bit more green here.
Is anybody
little more
else
blue.
Experiencing the camera going out of focus? I haven't seen that.
All right, so I want a little darker green here. So I'm going to make, I want my darker green color. So phthalo blue, ultramarine blue, and yellow. And let's make a darker green, wipe the brush. And I need a few little darker greens into my yellow flowers because they're too big of a mass, right? Got to break those up like that. And let's see, where did we go? We need a little bit of the green, lighter green growing up here on this side like that. Can maybe out this way now. This is our next lighter color, see? And let's come over here and add some lighter greens in here. Now light's coming down from the top. So this is our next lighter green. Remember, acrylics dry darker, so it can get very misleading when you're trying to put in your light greens. Because when you first do it, now let's put a little more white with that. I want the lightest greens kind of over here, like this. Okay, maybe up on this side like that. Okay, and let's see, where else could we put some? Maybe a couple up here like this.
Ramona would like to know, are the big pots really in front of the rail?
No, they're back behind the rail. We haven't put the rail on it yet. I would have put a rail down on these. I just didn't. I would have put a rail right down through here like that. I didn't do it on that one and should have. Good. It's a good question. I wasn't sure where I was going to need the green, so I just thought I'd wait and see where the green went before I did it. But yes,
it's missing the pole.
The rail is the rail is they right are they are definitely behind the rail like that. Okay. Like that. They're definitely behind the rail like this, and you would put the rail in like that. Okay. For sure. But you'd kind of do that last, but yeah, that's where they would absolutely go. They're not in front of the rail. And that's a good point. You know, and then you'd probably have a little bit of light on the rail too, like this. A little light on this rail like this, facing this direction. I didn't want to get too carried away with this, but there you go.
Oh, we got carried away.
All right, so there you go. Yeah, there's your rails. Yeah, absolutely. So the pots are behind the rails. Yeah, and then I think I like this design magenta. Let's use some of that. Or rather that quadrichrome. Let's put some of that color up here like this, because that's pretty. Let's just brighten up some of these like that. Ooh, isn't that nice? Oh, I like that bright pink, don't you guys? That's pretty. How about over here, too? Ooh, that's pretty. How about over here? What if we had a few little pink flowers right here we didn't have in the other picture, but we could have some growing out of this pot like that, and let's put a little more of that color out. Okay? Because you always want a little dark, too, see, not just the light. You always want two tones. Each flower should be two tones, darker color on the bottom, lighter color on the top, okay? Like that. There we go. That's pretty.
How many cookie lessons would you classify this?
Oh, I think this is like a two cookie lesson. This is pretty easy. I mean, I think the hardest part probably is just drawing and get a box in. I mean, there's nothing really tricky about this, really.
It's all pretty straight lines.
It's all pretty straight lines, and you know, you've got, the thing that I would say, here's the deal. I'm going to show you this right here, okay? Here's the deal. Here's my dark green, okay? So here's my flower, and it's got these dark green leaves like that, okay, like that. Here's my flower, something like this. Here's my darkest greens. The darkest greens are underneath. I don't care where is this growing, right? Now, when you start to put your flowers on top of this, right? When you start to put your flowers, you're going to say that's on top of this, right? Ideally speaking, it would be nice to dry it. Okay, but I just want you to kind of see what I'm talking about. Your darker flowers are kind of grouped together, and then the trick is they kind of bunch off into little tinier ones, okay, like as they go out, okay? So then the edge gets a little raggedy, and then you take some white, and then here's a light. People never understand where to put the white. Then here's the light. The light's on top, the dark's underneath. Does that make sense? So if you remember that, it doesn't matter what color you're doing, the light's on top, the dark's underneath, all right? So if you can kind of keep it like that, you know, I mean, you're in good shape. You know, you can say if you want another group of flowers growing up like this, saying up here, you can go as nutso as you want, and you would break this up by saying here's a light flower on top on here, and then maybe here's another light flower here, but you're breaking it. You always want some dark underneath the flowers, okay? Those are kind of bougainvillea, in case you were wondering what I was painting.
I was wondering what you were painting.
That's bougainvillea. All right, so here's our picture. And you can see, I mean, I still need some dark green. Remember, we talked about that. I need a little more dark green up in here. I kind of lost some of that. So I'm going to take a bite out of my flowers right here because I need a hole. Then I need a little bit of dark green coming down here like this on these pots, like that, over the top of these.
Cheryl would like to know, how should you dispose of your dirty water, your dirty paint water?
Just pour it down the sink, it's fine.
No, how should you?
Well, that's what I do, I pour it down the sink.
But how should you? There's all kinds of rules. If you go to Golden's website, Golden has
a whole
procedure.
Well, then ask Golden.
They have a whole procedure.
Well, if they have a whole procedure, then do what they do. That's not what I do. I pour it down the sink, and I've been doing it for years, and the only time I ever had a clogged sink
is when your tape went down.
When the tape goes down, or the brushes. You do not want to have your brushes go down the sink. May I say that this is a really terrible idea? I just want to mention that you know, having brushes go down the sink is one of the worst things. You know, for your that is a Roto-Rooter man call for sure. Okay, because I don't know. John will have to show you the stuff that was in our dryer. Now remember when I painted the this railing in? I probably should have put this blue first, but I didn't. So I didn't quite get this all painted in here. But there you go on the sides. But there you go. So, all right, that's our picture, and I think it looks kind of cute, don't you think, John?
You've done a fantastic job. I'm still dumbfounded.
I'm gonna
Sue Clark is giving this a 2.2. Well, basically, it's a two cookie with crumb lesson. It's a 2.2.
Okay, so then here's our railing here. Make sure we've got that dark in here. Here's our little dark shadow under here, like this. Under here, like that. There's our little stuff that's hooked up there. And there you go, you guys. I mean, and this could be even brighter. These flowers here still look a little green to me in the monitor. So I might just take some yellow like this and drop some bright yellow.
Oh, yes, we did find the missing remote. It was in the drawer. For those that don't remember, that was from the old camera. What was that, 6 months ago?
Yeah, we did find it. Didn't work anymore, though.
No, we'd have to recalibrate it back to that camera.
All right, so there's some yellow right there. So those are bright yellow flowers. There's our pink ones. This was sort of cute. I think we could still do a little bright green, some little bright green ones up in here like this.
Oh, it was
like
stuff in the washer.
Oh, you guys, you will not believe it. Did you show them the stuff in our washer?
No, Ginger, I didn't get a chance to load up. Tomorrow, you have to soak.
Okay, if you're here, we're going to show you what happened. We had to remember the refrigerator was last week, and this week it was the washing machine. Honestly, this week it was the washing machine, and I'll give John some credit. He really did make an effort to try and fix it, but there was it had its Humpty Dumpty moment.
It did.
And you guys know what I mean by Humpty Dumpty moment? All the king's horses and all the king's men couldn't put Humpty Dumpty bed together again. Every once in a while, there are things that have Humpty Dumpty moments, and that was certainly one. All right, so there's some pretty colors here. I'd say that we're pretty good on that. I think this is a fun thing. You could expand on this. Somebody else might want to put a cat up here on the balcony looking out. I know we've got some cat lovers in this group, and you might want to do that. And that's okay, too. You know, maybe you want a few. I think I want a few little leaves right in here like this, sort of break this up like this in the window, kind of like that. But, you know, have fun with this. You know, keep it light. Keep it fun. And share our stuff, you guys. If you haven't subscribed to this channel, please do invite your friends, you know, to come play with us. We think this is really, really fun. Did we show you? Oh, tomorrow night. You guys want to know what we're going to do tomorrow night?
Oh, I do. What are we going to do tomorrow night?
Okay, now. All right. What do you think?
Whoa.
Huh? What's wrong with this shirt? I'm not happy with it. Got to button it or something. All right, I'm going to move this out of the way. These are our ballet slippers. Well, they're not my ballet slippers, but they're ballet slippers. I thought this might be really nice in the sense that look at all the different colors and pink and the blending, this kind of stuff. And again, you know, we do this dark kind of background a lot. So I thought these ballet slippers will be fun. Again, this will be another one that will have a traceable, because I know this is kind of the shape of these could be challenging. And look, do you see how the string makes a heart? The ribbon makes a heart. Ooh, huh?
How'd you do that?
This was a really, really nice thing to do. And
what are we doing Wednesday? Somebody asked if we were painting Wednesdays. The last two Wednesdays we didn't.
Yeah, we're going to be painting Wednesday. We're going to be painting something. We're going to do something. I don't know. We'll do something.
We had something in mind.
We forget. But we'll do something fun. And we always like to do something fun. And if you haven't caught that one we did on perspective, that will help you so much. It's just all those photographs and how you can find the vanishing point. Make perspective easy. I said perspective for women, not to insult anybody, but I'm just saying that a lot of gals I know, we say that word, they go run screaming out of the room. We've made this really, really simple. I love what my friend Andrew said. This is the best explanation he ever heard for it, because it's really, look, they do a whole college course on perspective, and I'm going to tell you in an hour what you need to know most of the time to get through all your paintings. If you know this stuff, you're golden.
You're good to go.
You're good to go. So make sure you check those things and, you know, throw stuff in your playlist. That's an awful lot of fun to do. Again, here's our painting tonight, and I'm going to show you, let's move our color palette out of the way. So, you know, I think I got pretty close between the two of them, don't you think so?
I think you're
between the two, and you see we've got the, you know, kind of the shadow under here. This is a nice vignette, isn't it? And again, yes, could you do it like this? If you want to do it with real stucco, now you can. You're just going to have to do it in stages, and watch this video on how to do that, and then you could make that one the same way, and I would make it bigger, because, you know, you're just talking about a ratio here of the balcony to the window. All right?
Right.
Might be real fun to do, and I think you really would enjoy it.
Scale it up, people.
Fun.
All right, everybody. I think we had a wonderful lesson tonight. You guys hung in there with us. We appreciate the donations that came in. And Ginger, you did another fantastic job.
Oh, wait. Can I do one more thing?
Wait, there's still more.
We got in the mail. Where is it? Where's my stuff? Oh, yeah. We got in the mail. We got mail. We got mail, you guys.
We got mail.
Now, some people get lots of mail. We got one mail, but we got a good mail. This is from Gail in Chapel Hill, North Carolina, and she writes, "Hi, Ginger. Each time I watch your tutorials, I feel such gratitude towards you. So I'm sending this fabulous ornament she made herself. She said, I made especially for you. I know how much you love color. Thank you. Your heart is giving." So check this baby out. This is so beautiful. Look at that. Doesn't it go with our balcony piece?
Look at that.
Doesn't that go with this painting? This gal made this herself, and isn't that just beautiful? That is so gorgeous, and look how it goes. She just caught the color palette, didn't she? So, Gail, we thank you very much for that. That was so nice. And look at the bottom of it. It's got a little, I'm telling you, there. Those are the colors. How cool is this? So, you know, normally I would, this is going to go in a place of honor in my house. Thank you very much. I love it. Thank you. And then again, last chance, if you haven't done this video on YouTube, go look for this. I think I renamed this because I didn't like
it. Yeah, so good luck finding it.
I renamed this.
To what?
I think I called it
Gate?
No, it used to be called Rose Gate. I guess no one ever heard of that. I think I called it Flowers by the Gate or Flower Gate or something like that. Something like that.
There's only like 300 lessons to go through. I'm sure you can find it.
Yeah. And I think I have it in my playlist under favorites or something. Anyway. Find this. Cute this would go with this. I'm sorry. I think that would be a really good thing. Want you to do it. And if you're still into the flowers, come over to our website. Come paint this.
We got stuff to paint,
and we're here to help you paint it. Awesome. Good night.
Good night, everyone.
Thanks, Sammy.
Tomorrow at 7:30 Central, we'll be back at the same...
And painting the ballet slippers. How fun is that?
Painting the ballet slippers. Good night, everyone.
Night.
Night, Sammy. Night, Ginger.